Pop-off pump for diaphragm carburettors. Yeah, how do we do that the most complicated way? Yeah, like this. Play the music.
Thank you.
That was a lot of grinding and milling. No, not so much milling, but with the lathe. We mill with the mill with the lathe. Yeah. And then we can take this montage. I can explain how this works. First, we have the outlet that goes there. And this is this funny, for me at least, tread 1/8 NPT. And the same here for the gouge. I ordered a gouge that goes up to 60 psi. Then we have more control, because what I used before was this. This goes up to 210, and the first is 30. So we need more accurate measurements. So then we have the outlet, and here we have the inlet. It should be this tube that we glue on there. Then we have the plunger here. And we can think, when I drag this up for pumping down, we need air in. We can start with that. That is this valve. Very easy flapping inside. So when we drag up, it will just let air in from center hole through this and out in there, of course. Then this will go in there. And I hope this will, maybe we should have a bit of lubricant. And everything here is clean and use a lot of air. So, if I blow here, nothing, and suction, suction, and pressure down. So, then we have that. Then we have the top here. I don't need it, but when we are making this, I want to make it nice and things, yeah. You understand, if you are like that. So, and rubber O-ring. Many people do like this and just drag it on. Don't do that, because then you whirl it around. So you put it in the groove, hold with two fingers, and drag, and just let it go like that. And so when I push here now, the pressure, and yeah, it works. Then this have drilled in here and up there and up there. So of course we need a valve here also, the opposite way that I made from this, just a hex screw drill center. Thread it and put in a small, small valve that I have in my... Yeah, I had it. The only thing, I can say that, the only thing I buy was the gouge that are in the mail. And we put this down there. I put a rubber seal down there. like so. Then we need a gouge and we are finished. But we can glue this on and of course we will make this nice. Yes, we have it. It goes up to 60 psi, and then we will just put on some Teflon tape on this. Get it to be airtight. Like so. And then we have to check if this is airtight. We have a 4 mm outlet Festo connector. Then we just plug it with a blanking plug. Then we see. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah. And now we will test it on a carburetor. Now the setup is ready. And right there, we have the needle. Here we have the where the diaphragm is pushing. To open the valve to fill the chamber with fuel and pop-off pressure is when this valve opens. So if we follow closely now, and you will hear. About 12, 13, something. Yeah, almost 15, 14, maybe. Yeah, that's the pop-off pressure. Then we have something to look for. We do something there and we will have different results here. Then we know what we're doing. Yes, there you have it. And why did I do this so complicated? In all this mess now, I've done 3-4 projects at one time. So we need some cleaning and tidy up here. But this fits in there, goes in the box where all the carburetors things are. Then we have everything in one place, then just when we go out flying. So if someone needs help or I need to help myself, I have the tools. That's why. You can make this very simple with a
Bicycle pump and some hosing and valves, just at the local hardware store, maybe have that. But I wanted to do it like this. Then we have a dedicated tool for this. Oh, thank you for watching. And if you find this interesting, I will do more of these things. So please subscribe and hit that bell so you get the notifications also. So until next time, goodbye.